In the last episode, we were looking into Petronas 2-teller hydraulic fluid for the DRS system in our Formula One cars. Today, our focus will remain on the 2-teller hydraulic fluid, but this time for our clutch system and those all-important critical race starts. Welcome to the final episode in this six-part technical series, where we're delving deeper into the five Petronas functional fluids. So let's jump straight on in here, because I've not seen this part myself this up close. So Evan, what are we looking at here?
What we're looking at here is the clutch assembly, and anyone who's ever driven a manual transmission car will know a bit what a clutch is like. But of course, in a road car, that's quite a big and heavy assembly. And here we've got some pretty unique characteristics. In particular, we have to handle an engine on one side of the clutch that's going at thousands of RPM, generating unbelievable power. On the other side, a really tightly packaged transmission. And the clutch does the work of combining those two elements. So the first element we're looking at here is a housing with some cooling ducts that allow us to flow a bit of cold air over the clutch during operation. And then we'll touch on the heart of the clutch, which is a series of carbon plates. And you can see here we've got some splines on the outside of these plates. These are driven by the engine. So on the one side, we've got the engine driving those at up to about 15,000 RPM. And then a series of plates in between those with a central spline that's transferring torque through to the gearbox and allowing us to put that torque down to the ground during race starts. And then finally, what allows us to make that clutch do that work is the hydraulic actuator. So what we're looking at here is a hydraulic actuator with a line transferring pressure and fluid into the actuator, and then a motion that allows us to decouple the springs that hold that clutch tightly clamped and really carefully modulate the torque that's going into the clutch, putting that directly under the driver's control.
So Salvatore, looking at the 2-teller hydraulic fluid here, what are the key characteristics and what is it that you're trying to achieve?
So the Petronas 2-teller hydraulic fluid is a high performance anti-wear fluid that has to excel under every condition and on many applications. So we work in close partnership with NGP to develop a unique formulation which was designed for this application.
It does seem like it's put through an awful lot of pressure, and none more so than I imagine for a race at start. So how does this clutch engage for a race start?
So we're sitting on the grid. The engine is revving to about 9,000 or 10,000 RPM. That's of course spinning one side of the clutch. The gearbox on the other side of the clutch is completely stationary. And then in about 2 seconds, the driver engages the clutch. We clamp those plates together. They begin to transfer torque, and in doing so, generate an immense temperature. Within about 2 seconds, the clutch is fully closed. The car is doing 100 kilometers an hour, and the driver hopefully is flying by his rivals.
And you're talking about the immense high temperature. What kind of temperature will we be experiencing within that unit?
So for the clutch, it can reach around 500 degrees. The fluid can be reaching 200 degrees, so which is a really high temperature.
And I suppose reliability as well, under those kind of forces and temperatures, that must be key for the fluid.
Reliability is key for the clutch, so we guarantee anti-wear performance.
So Evan, we've mentioned the critical race start. Does it mean that the clutch just gets a bit of a rest to the rest of the time that it's going around the track?
No, the clutch, I'm afraid, really never has an easy moment. So, of course, the race start is the most critical moment. We're putting a lot of energy into it. But then the driver immediately needs to be shifting gears, and they need to be doing that repeatedly over the course of the race. So in our particular case, we don't use the clutch very much in upshifts, but it's absolutely critical in every downshift.
So we've got a chance here to take a closer look at the clutch. So can you talk us through it?
Yeah, absolutely. And what we're going to see here is the clutch in the context of the overall car, so we can really see where it's doing its work. So we're going to pause here just for a moment and look at the position of the clutch. So of course, what we're seeing here is a really complex engine broken down into a pretty simple diagram. Engine on the left-hand side. On the right-hand side, we're seeing the beginnings of the gearbox, the gear clusters, and the input shaft that transfers torque between those two things. And then the clutch is doing its work in this area, transferring torque from the engine through to the gearbox in a really controlled way. And if we have a look around the rest of the car, we'll get a better view of how the overall clutch operates. So here we're seeing the clutch in motion. So what we're seeing now, again, we have the engine. We have this basket of the clutch, which is driven by the engine, rotating at that same speed, so up to about 15,000 RPM on the straights. And then we have the input shaft going through to the gearbox. And when the car is stationary, that will be stationary. But when the car is on the straight at speed, these clutch plates are clamped together really, really tightly by a very powerful spring. So it's transferring all that speed and all that torque through pretty seamlessly without much power loss. When the time comes and we need to disengage the clutch, let's say for the race start or a gear shift, this powerful hydraulic actuator pulls the springs back, the plates are separated and they can move at different speeds. What that does mean, of course, is you've got 15,000 RPM on one side, nothing on the other, the plates are scrubbing against each other, they produce an immense amount of heat. And that's where, from the Petronas point of view, we're putting a pretty high demand on the system.
When the clutch is engaged, of course, you will release a lot of heat, which means that the hydraulic oil will reach high temperatures. Then we need to guarantee thermal stability on our fluid. Of course, we want the clutch to be engaged as quick as possible.
And there isn't actually very much fluid on the car, but on an F1 car, every gram is precious. So we have the smallest amount of hydraulic fluid we can possibly get away with, a tiny accumulator, and just the lines transferring that hydraulic power all around the car. And that does mean we're asking the system to do quite a lot of work with quite a small amount of fluid. So here we're looking again at the rest of the car. So again, seeing the springs rotating, the carbon plates rotating against each other, and the hydraulic actuator coming in from the back here, which is what's doing the work of pulling those springs apart and allowing the clutch to operate.
And I know, looking at anything hydraulic driven within the car, I'm just interested, is there a centralized unit, or does everything have its own container?
It's actually a unique unit and it's a unique fluid. So we use one hydraulic fluid to supply different parts in the car. So we already discussed it about DRS, but we have also power steering, we have the clutch, and we have the gearbox.
Wow, yeah, it's fully in use around the whole entire car.
Yeah, as Tori touched on, it's not just the same fluid, but it's actually the same reservoir of fluid in use throughout. So we have that hydraulic pump generating an incredible amount of pressure, and then a series of valves that allow us to direct that energy where we need it to all those various systems on the car, which does mean that fluid needs to be pretty capable of handling different applications. So some of those are happening at the same time. We might be opening the DRS at the same time as downshifting. We're certainly using the gearbox at the same time as other elements on the car. So quite a lot of demand on that system.
So there we have it. The Petronas Tutela hydraulic fluid for the clutch system is essential for that seamless operation, especially for those race starts. Thank you so much for watching these 6 episodes while we've been delving deeper into the Petronas 5 functional fluids that assist our Mercedes-AMG Petronas F1 cars to go racing. If you've missed out on any episodes so far, you can now go back and catch up on any that you need to. And don't forget to drop us a comment or leave your questions.